Hi everyone, it's Meher from Vancouver, BC, and welcome to my YouTube channel. The purpose of my videos is to introduce you to tips that will help you elevate your job search by interviewing experts in the field. By the end of each video, you will fill it with knowledge that will help you in your job search strategy. And if you are a first-time viewer, please subscribe to the channel so that you get the notification every day I post a new video. So let's start with today's interview. Hi everyone, welcome back to another interview series with me. Today I have the privilege to interview Chip Conley. Hi Chip, how are you doing?
Thank you, Mara. It's great to be with you.
Thank you for being here. So Chip is an entrepreneur and New York Times best-selling author who started a boutique hotel company called Joie de Vivre 33 years ago, then moved to Airbnb as head of global hospitality and strategy, and helped the founders grow Airbnb from an airbed in their living room to the largest hospitality company in the world that we know. Chip also is the author of Wisdom of Work, and who has recently started an elderly academy to change the world's perception of aging. Chip, my first question for you is, if you can tell us something from your journey as an entrepreneur, what struggles you had and how that struggles or obstacles help you in your career?
So quite often an entrepreneur is a pioneer. They're a visionary. And the word visionary really means you can see the future earlier than other people. Mm-hmm. I like to think of a metaphor of a surfer. A surfer can actually look at the horizon and see the waves coming in and know which is the right wave to catch. So whether it was as an early pioneer of boutique hotels, which was a new phenomena in the 1980s in the United States, or whether it was more recently, 6.5 years ago, joining the founders of Airbnb in home sharing, I have been open to trying new things that people said to me were stupid. So I think that the number one way I'd answer that question is an entrepreneur needs to believe in their concept and in the wave that they're catching well enough so that they can accept criticism or people saying that's a stupid idea.
Yeah. And a lot of these days, a lot of people are criticizing, especially with social media. If you're trying something new and they don't accept it, they criticize. So how, as an entrepreneur or maybe young entrepreneur, can accept those criticism or those struggles to stay focused on their dream?
So I think the question I always ask in general, but especially in social media, is when people have said something critical, are they assuming best intention? So I'm a big believer that in life, it's best to assume best intention in other people. Now, that will mean occasionally I will have somebody who takes advantage of me. It doesn't happen very often. And my intuition's pretty good. So if I see that, I walk the other direction. But if someone is giving me constructive advice and it's coming from a place of what I think is best intention, a good intention, then I take that advice constructively, you know, and I listen to it. Now, there's times I may disagree with it and I won't pursue it. There are other times when sometimes the way someone actually expresses it makes you react negatively to it, but actually hidden inside of that criticism is really beautiful advice. It's almost like you have a free consultant suggesting something to you. And that's when I really look at how do I reduce my reactivity and instead look at the core of what they are saying, even if the way they're saying it is not very diplomatic.
That's a nice advice, Chip. Thank you for that. And for the audience, if you have any other tips in terms of entrepreneurs, how they can keep track in struggling or at the beginning, please leave it in the comment section. Like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and tune in tomorrow for another question with Chip.